jumping right in. We are jumping right in. Part 2. I want to talk about accountability. Part 3 is going to be looking for a healthy church. Okay? So part 2 is accountability. Real accountability. First, I want to talk about what accountability is, and then I'm going to talk about real versus fake. Now, let me talk about real accountability. Real accountability is when you are genuinely exposing yourself as best you can to a select group of people. Few people. I would suggest 3 people, not more than 3. Because it's going to be so confusing, and it's very, very difficult to trust others. And it's very difficult, especially if you've been hurt before and you've been betrayed and all of that stuff. Very hard to trust others. So I would say maybe 2 accountability partners, 2 to 3. I would never say just 1. I would never say more than 3 because it's so confusing. So 2 to 3 is so wonderful and just perfect for me. This is just my opinion. Okay? If you look at the church today, a lot of people say, oh, I'm accountable to my church. Like, really? The whole church? Everyone knows about everything in your life? I don't think so. So what is a picture of real accountability? First, I would say a very small, intimate group of people, maybe 2 to 3 people. Secondly, it must be the same sex. If you're a guy, just guys. If you're a girl, just girls. That's second. Another point on accountability, you should be, you guys, the 3 of you or 4 of you, should have a very clear agreement that whenever you confess a sin or an issue, the first thing that they will do is listen, not judge, not condemn, not give advice, just listen first to let you finish, let you air out everything and give all the details. And then the second step is to pray before giving advice. Pray first. After the prayer, then talk about it. Then the advice comes. You must have an agreement that when they call you out on a certain behavior that you're doing, that you will not get defensive. You have to remind one another, I am for your good, I am for your growth, I am for your sanctification, I am not against you, I am for you. So whenever I call you out, it's not because I hate you, it's because I love you. And you have to trust one another because I love you very much as a brother, or, you know, for girls, as a sister, I gotta say these things to you for your own good. So there's trust, right? There's trust, there's love, there's patience, there's grace, there's listening and praying before giving advice. Another thing about accountability is you're genuinely trying to expose yourself to these men or women. You're trying to figure things out to become more sanctified in Christ. You're not hiding stuff. So guys, accountability is not talking about the weather or talking about the sins that you know are easy. So let me just go straight into the painful ones. If you're a guy, here's a suggestion. If you're a guy, if you've got an accountability partner, both of you, meet once a week and ask each other, have you watched pornography lately? Have you watched porn this week? Ask those questions. Have you stolen anything this week? Have you lied this week? If you're married, have you looked at anyone lustfully? Or have you had any sexual desire for someone else who's not your wife recently or within the week? Those are the painful questions. Those are the tough ones. You know, if you know the person has a problem with alcohol, have you drank anything lately? Have you been drunk? Have you impulsively purchased anything if the person has a financial issue, right? So ask the tough questions. There's a really, really, really good book I highly recommend. The title is The Accountable Man, written by Tom Eisenman. That used to be in OMF. I know it's on Amazon. I know there's an Amazon version of this. I'm not sure if there's a Kindle. Yeah, I think there's a Kindle version. I think Google Books also has it. So The Accountable Man by Tom Eisenman, which is very useful for women as well. The questions there are also for women. Very powerful book. I went through that with some friends in the past. It's very, very good. And I'm going to bring this up with our church as well, actually, and would recommend the men to go through this too. Okay, accountability also means they can see you, which brings me to fake accountability. Let me say it straight. Your accountability partners must be formal members of your local church. If your accountability partner is not from your local church, it's fake. It's not going to work. I don't care what you say. I don't care. Oh, but we talk with da-da-da. I don't care. That's fake accountability. Why? Because if the person cannot see you, if it's digital or online, you're not truly transparent, you're not truly accountable. And if you're gonna insist on that, then I would also insist that you're using that as an excuse. You're pretending to be accountable, but you're not. You're just trying to find a way to say that you're accountable so that no one can really tell you to repent of certain issues in your life. Why do I say this? Because in the first place, if the person cannot see you, if you're not in the same local church, if you're not formal members of the same local church, they don't really know the sermons you're hearing. They, you know, your accountability partner and you, you're supposed to know one another very well. If they don't see your reaction, if they don't see you, if they're not hanging out with you, then the only information they get about you is the stuff that you say. Now, you can be so sincere in trying to tell them everything about you, but you've got blind spots. So you're not going to be able to tell them the things about your life that you yourself cannot see because you've got blind spots. So even if you're the most sincere accountability partner out there, you are still going to have blind spots which you cannot expose. Obviously because you can't see them, right? So that's fake accountability. So even if you're the most sincere, you cannot be truly accountable. How much more if you're shy, if you want to fake things? The only things they'll know about you is whatever you say to them and expose to them. But they'll never be able to truly call you out if they don't see you, they don't hang out with you, and all of that stuff. So same thing, mentorship and stuff, same church. Gotta be same church. If you're a pastor or an elder, you need to have multiple pastors or multiple elders in your church, and you guys as elders should be accountable and transparent to one another. How about mentoring? Get mentorship from one another. Study books together, enroll in those mentorship classes together, but you guys are the accountability partners for one another. I've had friends ask me, bro, could you be my mentor in this area of my life, be it ministry? Another one wanted me to be their mentor for relationships and romance. Another one for ministry. Another one for, you know, like business and stuff. And they're not from our church. And I would always say no. And I'm not saying this to toot my own horn, because I've also asked other people to be my mentor in certain areas, and it just doesn't work because they don't really know me and I don't really know them. So to be very, very safe, we just say no to those, and we look within our own local churches, within our formal membership roster, and then intentionally build relationship with them. So that's real accountability, guys. Like, just look for someone from within your local church, talk to them, be accountable to them, be transparent, and then lay out the ground rules. Or better yet, just read The Accountable Man by Tom Eisenman, and then tell someone in your church to read it with you, and then ask them, hey, you want to do this with me? You want to get into this nitty-gritty stuff? And then really hash things out. That's what I would suggest. And a part 3 is coming, how to find a healthy church, all right? God bless you guys.